Oh my god. Oh my god.
Ooh.
What is that?
What's up, dude? What is up, y'all? Just take a look at this really quickly. This is actually pretty crazy. So there's a creek all the way over there. Then all this is supposed to be just grass, completely freaking flooded. Past 2 days, we got so much rain.
Sheesh.
Just things like double the size. Peep current, peep chocolate milk game. It's got that little frappe on the top.
I just wanted to show you guys that the past 2 days, Delaware has got wet.
Oh my God, that is a thick boy.
But yeah, I wanted to show you guys that. And then also look at this over here, man. What the heck?
Sheesh.
It is actually very, very chilly today. With that rain, I guess we got a massive cold front. I just witnessed a squirrel doing like a helicopter tail. I don't know what maneuver that was. Yeah, let me show you guys. We got something pretty cool, man. So in one of my previous Walmart excursions looking for fishing gear, I actually got, I'm not gonna show you guys. My thing is a mess here. A lot of the time, like a lot of the comments I read, a lot of you guys want me to go catfishing. I'm a big fan of catfishing. Every time I go, I feel like it's one of those types of fishing where I'm just like, yo, I need to do this more. Anyway, so we were bopping around Walmart and I stumbled across something in the fishing section that I've actually never seen before. And it's something that I feel like is gonna be pretty cool to test. So look at this thing right here, man.
This is the Catch It Catfish Kit. First of all, I've never actually used a catfish kit, but second of all, this thing was extremely, extremely cheap. I think if I remember correctly, it was around like $5-ish. Let me just show you guys, man. I mean, you pretty much get everything you need here. You get 3 tied spring hooks. It's pretty interesting. So there's like snelled hooks and then they have springs on the end, I guess to hold the dough bait or whatever you get. You get 3 weights, 3 swivels, and 1 bait. This is not for human consumption. Oh, for $5. Oh, there's another. Can you guys see that? Fat freaking squirrel, dude. I don't know, I guess people come here and they feed, or oh, must be stocking up on some nuts or something. Either that or they're loaded with McDonald's. I also, dude, is this, it's not from squirrels, right? I'm telling y'all, I don't know what the heck they be feeding these things. Fun and easy to do. Homeboy on the back, hello. My man's a straight cheesing. Yo, if you are this kid and you're somehow watching this video, man, I just want to say hi. So this is, I guess, the Magic Bait Company. By again, this is not sponsored. It actually shows you what knots and what rigs are baiting the hook. And good luck and good fishing. I appreciate that. Made in Guthrie. Okay. Please don't litter.
This is kind of comparable, I guess, to like if you go to the store. I mean, you could just buy some night crawlers. They're what, like 2-3 bucks? You could also just like get a cheap can of corn.
I don't believe I've ever used this kind of catfish bait before, this kind of like brown turd looking thing.
So we're gonna see, man, is this bait worth it? Is this kit worth it? The cool thing is that, you know, it's at Walmart. So if you guys wanna pick it out, you probably got a Walmart here. I also have some secret weapons too, if this does not really work to catch anything.
Are you a photographer?
That was a nice lady, shout out to that lady. But yeah, we're gonna get rigged up here. We're gonna go over to this pond. That, or actually it's a lake, but there's a bunch of different kinds of species in here, a bunch of different kinds of catfish. If you guys have been enjoying the videos or if you're new here, make sure to go down there and hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell so you never miss an upload. Also, man, if you could hit that like button, it would mean a lot to me. All right, let's get over here. Let's see what we could do today.
Hey, yo, I have never seen a freaking trash can this big. Should we look in it? I feel like one of those squirrels is gonna pop out. Hello? Oh, there's like nothing in there. Hey, look at all these leaves, man. Wind is blowing them around. This is a nice day. Definitely chilly, man. It was really hot and now it's, yeah, now it feels like November. Ooh, see, I would hate to be that guy, but like I would really like to fish like right where your whole squad is at. I'll just yeah, we can coexist. All right. Oh, right where I'm gonna cast. I guess I deserve that. Oh, your friends just left, my guy. All right, Goose Poop Central. This is where we're setting up here. I have these two rod holder thingies. We're gonna right here, shove her in, and then right, shove her in right there. Ooh, that one went deep. The wildlife is real out here today. So we got the goose army, like a little seagull posse out there. There's 5 seagulls floating in a random lake and middle of Delaware. We're not even anywhere near the beach. Do you guys have like seagulls? Like all you guys who live not near the beach or like in the middle of the country, like are seagulls a thing?
Let's crack her open right here. Oh, she's taped up.
That is some freaking strong tape, dude. Oh, no, I ruined my directions. All right, so here, that's a tiny little bag. Magic Bait, America's favorite catfish bait. That literally looks like some freaking turds. I'll blend in right with the goose poop. And then, okay. Oh, dude, those look so
Interesting. So I've never actually, like, I feel like that's a thing. The catfishermen, they use stuff like this. So, like, I guess the bait sticks in the springs. I've seen a bunch of different weird rigs. I really do want to start getting into more of the catfishing stuff because I think it's pretty cool. But, yeah, I've never actually used anything like that. Good thing I ripped up my directions. I guess another thing I didn't mention is the rods we're going to be using today are pretty light. So if we get any monsters biting, this is gonna be a fight. Wait, I did that wrong, didn't I? I definitely did that wrong. Add weight to the main line and then tie swivel. Okay, so yeah, no, this is like a normal catfish. What am I doing, dude? Okay, no, yeah, that's actually pretty simple. So we clip this onto the snell, so we have a little weight, can bop around like that. That goes down to the swivel, which I would normally just use a swivel. They have a snap, so I snapped the snap to the little snell, and then we have this hook. Now, I don't know how this hook, do I have to load it? Like, it's weird. Is that going to affect the hookup? Press bait onto hook covering point. What do you guys think magic bait smells like? Goose poop scent. Oh, wow. Oh, my God. It smells like, oh, my gosh. You ever been to, like, a petting zoo or, like, a farm? That is exactly. Okay, so what's the point of, oh, this is falling apart. It's kind of got, like, a fudgy brownie kind of consistency. But yeah, it smells straight up. Like, if you guys ever been to a petting zoo or a farm or, oh my gosh. Just imagine that smell rocketed up your nostril. That is what that looks like. Straight up cosmic brownie looking like. Hi, how's it going? No, I just got over here. Good luck, guys. All right, so one last look at the rig here. Got the weight going down to the snap swivel, going down to the leader, going down to this dude. I don't know. I mean, there's a lot of springs. Am I supposed to smash it all in this spring? I don't freaking know what I'm doing, man. Now, you guys have seen me fish here if you've been watching the channel for a while. And that actually stayed on, so that's good. There's a couple different species of fish in here, man. And there's a couple, I mean, there's bullhead in here. What are they called? Channel catfish? Like, yeah, dude, apparently there's like some giant, giant channel catfish in here. There's blue catfish. Apparently there's even striped bass that people catch and then they actually release them in here. There's big old bass. I don't know what else. I mean, a bunch of other panfish and just a bunch of stuff, man. We were catching white perch before on some of this catfish bait. I just, like, I don't know. I need to start catfishing more, man. This is cool. We have the thing in the ground. We got the thing in the ground. The thing is in the water. So really, I mean, I don't even care. We're just fishing for anything that bites. I hope, like, that it would be really cool to get a big old catfish. There's also big carp in here. I need to go carp fishing. Hopefully we catch one of those today, but at the same time, hopefully we don't because I don't have a net or, yeah. Very prepared as always. All right. I'm gonna do the same thing on this rod. Hey, let me know, man. If you guys are out here, you guys are doing some catfishing, what is your go-to catfish bait and what's your go-to catfish rig? As I keep saying, I still have a lot to learn when it comes to all this stuff. I mean, there's some very unique rigs that people run, especially even more, man. Carp fishing is like a whole different art form. There's so much like crazy looking, I don't know. I wanna explore more into those realms, especially as it gets colder, man. The bite for pretty much virtually everything else is going to dwindle. And catfish and carp could be my only, you know, opportunity at some points. Rig number two, very identical. I feel like, though, that's not how you do that, right? I mean, it's kind of in the springs, though. It's like covering the hook. All right, let's whip that dude out that way. What the heck is my thing? Oh, there we go. Blends in with the ground. Colorblind problems. Drag is loose on that one. All right, this water does kind of look, yeah, chocolate milky. There's some visibility. Well, I mean, we're just kind of hoping that the scent and the taste gets the attention, something big. Definitely let me know, too, if you guys want to see me do more catfishing challenges. I have a couple of different spots. We might actually hit up another spot today if this is, I'm not going to say, it's going to be productive here. But, oh, geez, I have a couple different other spots that I want to hit. Apparently, I have some giants as well, a couple different kinds of catfish. Let me know if you guys like want to see me go to Cabela's. If you remember, that catfish session there is insane. We do like a cool fishing challenge. Let's get two of these dudes out. While we're just standing and waiting here, we could be a little bit productive, man. I'm just gonna kind of rip these up, ball them up a little bit. This is definitely gonna get my hands smelling a little stanky. Yeah. Let's get a little bit more of that scent in there, man. You can always use a little bit more scent, right? Yeah. Two more pieces. All right. That should be good. I feel better now. I know I've said it before too. One of my favorite parts about coming to fish, especially in like public spots like this where people are walking around, a lot of people bring their dogs and you get to see just like a bunch of dogs roaming around. The wind is making them twitch a little bit. One message I do kind of want to spread in this video, just positivity, man. I know it's getting to that time of the year where fishing, you know, it could be hard for, you know, a lot of different states and a lot of different areas. Crazy thing is, I know some of you guys already have ice, which, I mean, maybe you like that, maybe you don't. That's just crazy to me. Trust me, man, if you're out there and fishing,
It's not a bad day. If you're catching, if you're not catching, I mean, this is getting a little deep here, but that's the same thing with life, you know? If any of y'all are stressed out or you had a hard, difficult point in your life, just look on the positive side, man. Each and every one of us has stuff to be thankful for, and if you just kind of look that way, just makes life a little bit better. I don't know, that got a little deep there. I was actually pretty frustrated. I don't know if you guys saw my last video. That video took a long time. I mean, you guys can imagine, over 20 something hours to film and edit and post and everything. I really liked that video. So what happened, I posted it, then YouTube just croaked. The site was down, I mean, for somewhere a long, long time. Like, I think 3-4 something hours. In my area, it was down over 2 hours, and there was a problem with my video. Like, a lot of people couldn't see it after they, like, it was a big mess. So I ended up re-uploading the video the next day, which was very, like, frustrating. And in that video, I mean, some people already saw it, and then it just did the algorithm, like, it, yeah. So if you guys have not seen that video, if you guys want to go check that out, that would mean a lot to me. But again, I mean, looking on the positive side, I still got to share that adventure with you guys. And, you know, I'm just very fortunate to be able to do this kind of stuff, you know? I'm actually planning on making a video, kind of like a day in life, and just talking about, you know, what goes on in the fishing YouTube world in the day. Does that make any sense? Let me know what you guys want to know about in that video. That's going to be a really cool video, man. I don't know. What do you guys think? Is it the bait? I'm going to reel this one in. What is going on, man? Yeah, it's still there. Am I supposed to fill up that whole spring? Like, I could put two different dough balls? Okay, that's bigger.
This is a big old turd.
If I was a catfish, there's no way I would not eat this. Okay. How's it going, man?
Have you had any luck yet?
Nah.
Not yet?
Nothing.
Okay.
How about you?
I had a strike run down in the creek.
Yeah?
Yeah, I lost him.
Oh, man.
Yeah, it should be a good day.
Yeah, good luck, man.
Thank you.
Nice. Now, where can I poke this? All right. Turd number one. Boom. That's a good possibility. We'll get snagged, and or this weight is not going to be strong enough. All right. Here's what's going on, man. These snaps are hard to snap. Whoa. All right, so we came back over to this spot. I just have a lot of faith in here, and down there, like down at the spillway, it was just too fast. The rigs were getting all tangled up and everything. So we have now, look at this. I don't even know. There you go. Is that lighting good? Freaking loaded with corn. I actually figured out how to take the spring off. I don't know. Did I have the spring on right when I was using the spring? Now we have one rod filled with corn. I've caught catfish here on corn before. I've caught carp on corn. This is a pretty decently big hook though. But now we have even more of an experiment going on. We got the corn, and then we have the magic bait that is not so magical right now. This is a secret weapon I was talking about, man. Oh. Kelsey, if you're watching this is not what it looks like. Usually she gets corn for corn purposes. These ones don't have the thing. Oh yeah. Pour one out for the catfish gods. It's a freaking mess, man. I had to get a rock and smash the rock, and we need this open a little bit better here. Oh boy. I just got bit on the corn. Got a freaking fish. Got a fish. On the freaking corn, dude. Is it the magic bait? Is that the issue? Is that big? I know this is a smaller rod. Come here, boy. This feels so freaking good. Please come here. I mean, this literally hook was loaded. Oh. This was loaded with corn. Okay. Let's go, dude. Let's freaking go.
Okay,
like, it's not the kit's fault
yet, right? Like, it still helped us catch
fish. We used the same hook. I just took the
oh, he just pooped.
But yeah, we used the same hook. I just took the little spring out, which I'm not really sure I'm using the spring right anyway. That's all we had. I mean, that was loaded with corn. This dude got a meal. Like, I appreciate you so much, buddy. Just, there you go. And look at that mouth. Crazy. I mean, that is a
some kind of bullhead.
It's just weird though, like, that wasn't in there for that long. So if these kind of fish are here, like, why wouldn't they eat the magic bait? Bait's supposed to be magic. But yeah, look at that, man. You see a little kernel in there. I appreciate you. I don't know what happened to your face. That's just what makes you unique. We're all unique in our own way. Oh, that water is cold. Let's go, dude. All right, let's put some more freaking corn on that. I don't know. It's not, I'm not saying it's the kit, man. Maybe the fish are finally here and around here. I don't know. If anything, I mean, the kit's nice just to have all this other stuff so far. If you got a rod and you don't have any other catfish stuff, I mean, it makes it easy, right? Long time out here.
for that one bullhead. Let me know what kind of bullhead that was too. I know there's different types.
I'm telling you guys that.
Corn is just the OG secret weapon shining in the sunlight. I actually put two of these balls on here too because we were down in there and it was kind of, yeah, I don't know, we're gonna throw this back. I did recently just check that other rod too. There's still some turds on it. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Come on, man.
We're gonna get some more fish, man. I feel it. It's been chilly. It's been a while. It's been windy. But that
just made it all worth it right there, man.
Public body of water, November, trying to catch some catfish on a kit.
Do you ever just think, like, look at these two ducks right here. There's one, I don't know which one's the male, which one's the female. I guess they're partners. Where do you think, like, they're going that way? Where are they going? What are they thinking?
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Took the freaking rod holder with me. Hello. All in the corn again. What do we got there? Oh, that's definitely catfish. What is it though? Oh, jeez. Hold on, that's fighting a little bit better than the last one. Ooh, what is that? Come here, come here, come here, come here. Come here. Let's freaking go, dude. Okay, that is actually, look how pretty.
We got ourselves a bullhead buffet. Oh, you hear that?
He's speaking to us. We got a bullhead buffet out here.
They do be munching the corn.
Okay. Let's get them leaves off him. Second one of the day. This one's significantly actually bigger than the first one. Pretty freaking fish, man. I mean, they got some definitely interesting looking eyes. Oh yeah, that's some better lighting. What the heck am I doing, man? Look at that. Beautiful freaking fish.
What are you doing, Magic?
Interesting that both those were bullhead. Again, if you know what kind of bullhead, I don't freaking know.
Where's my hole, dude?
I don't even know if you guys saw it. This thing started going. I straight up yoinked it out. The holder was still on it.
That was fun, man. That got me excited.
Maybe as like the sun starts to set a little bit more, it'll really, really start to turn on here. That's fun, man. I like catching those, especially on this smaller setup too. Some things were yoinking.
Yep. Still on there.
Rip turd.
Maybe, like, let's try to really bomb this. Bomb this.
Whoa. That's a fish. Let's go, dude. That feels actually better. Loosen that a little bit. Oh. Oh. What do you got here? Third one of day, whatever it is. It's definitely a catfish.
Ooh. Bro,
I'll tell you guys, man, it is a freaking bullhead buffet. I'm trying not to put this dude in the grass. Oh yeah, he's speaking to us. Well, at least we know the bullhead have been having a great time with the corn. Look at that beautiful freaking, like, they actually look so sick, man. Really cool fish. Underrated fish. I feel like they don't get appreciated enough. It's like that one TikTok.
I just want to be appreciated.
Oh, my. Okay.
You want to know just where?